G'day guys, today the crew goes scientific.
We're here at ANSTO in Sydney,
taking a look at the world of nuclear science.
Today at ANSTO we take a look at the STAR Accelerator. STAR uses the force of static electricity to accelerate streams of charged particles at very high speeds. These ion beams are used to analyse substances in areas of environmental science, archaeology, geology, solid state analysis, as well as general research.
This is David Cohen, a leading Australian physicist. Tell us about the accelerator.
Hi. What we have behind you here is a 2 million volt Tandetron accelerator. And what that does is it accelerates charged particles to exceedingly fast speeds or velocities, usually up around 2 or 3% the speed of light. And what we do is we fire them at targets and they go straight through the targets and come out the other side. And as they go through, they do some really interesting things which we use to characterise the target that these very fast ion beams have been through.
How does the accelerator work?
Have you ever combed your hair in a dry thing and you get this electrostatic charge on it? Well, that's really how the accelerator works. You take an atom, you strip an electron off an atom and it becomes an ion. We have a voltage, 2 million volts, on this small machine behind you. And we put an ion into that 2 million volts and it's accelerated, pulled along through there. And that's where we get up to these relativistic speeds, 1 or 2, 3%, 4% speed of light. To get them to go these long distances that you can see here, 10, 20, 30 metres, and transport them, we actually put them in these tubes here, these vacuum tubes. Once the air's out, we can transport these things over tens of metres before we smash them into our target. As these ions pass through the material, they can interact with electrons, which are the particles that go around the outside of the atom. And if they do that, they give off X-rays. If they go along the ions and interact with the nucleus in the centre of the atom, then they give off gamma rays. The third method is where the ion actually interacts with the nucleus. The nucleus is pretty small. It's like a golf ball in the middle of a football field. But if you actually hit the nucleus then it can, with the ion, it can bounce back at you, like billiards on a billiard ball table. And we know the energy it went in at, we know the energy it comes back at. The only unknown is what it hit. And so we can then find out what it hit, and therefore we know about the material because we know what we've hit. So we have two X-ray detectors, one gamma ray detector, and the other detectors are inside the chamber here, which you can't see because I can't take the lid off.
So what sort of things do you learn from this research?
Well, as an example, if we go to the environmental stuff I was telling you about, we go out into the general community at the moment. We've got some 30 or 40 samplers running all around Australia and all through Asia, picking up ambient air, the normal air that you breathe every day. Mm-hmm. We put that into a filter paper by sucking ambient air through it. The particles end up on the filter paper, and then we put them in our machine, and we fire these beams that I was telling you about through them. So if you know what's in the air and where it comes from, then you can manage it. And you can work out the best way to spend a dollar to make the air as clean as what it is on most days in Sydney.
So to finish up, what's the best thing about your job here at ANSTO?
I think I interact with a lot of clever people from all around the world. Although we're using accelerators every day, the application of these accelerators is in many, many different areas. And each year we have about 120 different visitors come in a year. And we interact with 37 different universities, which is nearly every university in Australia. Mm-hmm. So I guess for me, the interesting part is the variety of the job, the excitement of the job, and interacting with so many different people that have so many different problems in so many different disciplines.
Thanks so much for your time, David, and good luck for the rest of your work.
Okay, I enjoyed it. Have a good day.
Thank you.